Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Settlers Saturday, episode 117 today, guys. We are playing the Dark Tribe. If you've missed out on the last few episodes, we're here on the Dark Tribe. This is actually level 2, mission 2 of the Dark Tribe, and so this would be the second episode of the second mission of the Dark Tribe. But all you regulars, you guys know that already. Why do I explain it every episode? I don't know. We've made a little bit of progress here. I think pretty slow, though. I'm not too happy with the pace of the speed here. Look, we've got some gold here. Yeah, we found some pretty cool resources along the way. A tiny little bit of iron. A little bit of coal as well. While I'm explaining things here, I think I'll... let's get a tower down here. Let's try and expand down this way a little bit. Yeah. We might as well. We might as well claim this area here, and it's a nice looking area. We're going to need a little bit of area for our food as well, so we've got no food production set up whatsoever, and we really kind of want a few troops. Would you guys agree? I'm thinking let's get some troops out here, but it looks like that's not happening. So far we've got we've got one iron mine here. We've got one iron smelter, a toolsmith. Is this anything? No. I think that was something. It must have been a tower at one point. I'm very happy about the placement of the smelting works. That's absolutely like as close as possible to the mountain here. That's really cool. I'm happy about that. Yeah, and then we explored over here. There's a little bit of coal and gold and things. Good things to explore. And this guy here is guarding the stone. Of course, in Settlers 4, when you kind of walk away and the fog of war sets in, the stone kind of disappears. Look at this. Come on, don't let me down now. Okay, there it is. So this bit of stone here has all disappeared. So we've got this guy here guarding the stone. Yeah, because we don't want to lose that. We definitely want to keep track of that. I mean, we've got a good supply here, but we might as well keep going. Oh, it looks like the stone carries on all the way to here, so there's loads of stone here. Oops, sorry about that. My door came open, and I went to pause the game and cancelled the recording, so silly me. So yeah, I think, what should we do for this episode? We should definitely work on a food situation here. Like I say, I think we should maybe make use of this stone down here and get another stone cutter. We've got the toolsmith as well, so we could think about getting another woodcutter just to kind of max things out here. That would be nice to see. Though we need to make a nice supply of shovels, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're going to need quite a few shovels. So, they squeeze in so nicely, like there. Fits in nicely there. Okay. So, yeah, that was a storage area. Once that's built, we're going to store a few shovels, I think. Stone has been found. Okay, we could work on that as well. For now, though, let's go for some food production. A grain farm, then, I think. Now, of course, you want the grain farm to be on a nice flat area. So, we'll build it. We'll build the grain farm. Actually, first, before we do anything, let's place another tower. And then, with the remaining space, let's squeeze in a grain farm. Cool. And let's post that over there. Cool. Crush this small tower. We don't want that. We can use that guard. We can recycle that guard. Be as efficient as possible. And, yeah, then let's squeeze in a stone cutter down here. Do we have the pickaxes for it? Yeah, we got loads of pickaxes. Look at that, we got 3 pickaxes, so we're all good. Do we have any scythes? Yes, we've got a couple of scythes as well, so that's all good as well. Now, last episode, one of you guys mentioned... Who was it? Was it my boy Johnny Dude? shout out to you, man, for always being there. There's a lot of you guys that come back every week, so I really do appreciate it. Not just one person, but all of you guys. I'm pretty sure it was him anyway that said... You should really listen to the mission name. This mission, the name of this particular mission is Stabbed in the Back. Which, think about that for a second. I think, he mentioned that the AI, the Mayans, there are some Mayans over here. We kind of found them over here. They're supposed to be our enemy, our allies even. It should be the Romans and the Mayans have allied up against the Dark Tribe, but we're not actually allies. You know, obviously I can't see that guy's base, I can't see what he's doing, so we're not actually allies. So they probably are going to attack us at some point. We can't just leave our defenses open. When we go to attack the Dark Tribe, we've got to leave a few guys at home just in case the Mayans do decide to attack us, which would be pretty shitty. Pretty shitty indeed. We've got this one fisherman as well. I'm thinking about food distribution. Let's go to the distribution of fish. Oh, we've already done it. I've done it before. We've cranked up the iron and cranked up coal. It looks like that one fisherman's hook can't really keep up. The one fisherman's hook can't keep pace with it. So let's build a couple more. Do we have any rods? No, we don't. Okay. I think it's a good start though. Let's go for a couple fisherman's hook. This guy's got it good though. Look at this guy. He's living the life just out there on his island. That's such a lovely spot. Some of you guys mentioned how lovely that lake is, man. That's such a beautiful little lake with this one guy just living the life. Let's get the fish. I don't think we can squeeze anything else up here. Like, this is perfect for fish. Could we squeeze in? I always lose track of these things. Yeah, we can't. There's no way we can get an iron smelter or even a toolsmith in there. Definitely not a weapon. Oh, we could get a weapon smelter in there. But we've got space over there for a weapon smelter. I'm just thinking there's no other space for anything else up there. So let's squeeze in fish. For sure. There we go. A couple fishermen's huts. Yeah, there's a few fish swimming around. They're ready. They want to be caught. They want to be eaten. Like, eat me. Eat me. So let's get those built as fast as possible. And then we'll go to the toolsmith, of course, and request a couple rods there. Thank you very much. And already we've conquered this land down here. So we'll go to the small tower again. And, normally I'd just capture the land like here, right? But then there's this. This is like unusable swamp land. So, I don't know which way to go here. Let's go like that. Let's do that. Okay. It's probably a waste of resources building a tower there. We could probably get a lot more done with our pioneers, but they have a more important job to do. They're claiming land in this direction. Nice mine for a sulfur. Nice, what was it saying? Something about sulfur. Nice spot for a sulfur mine. That was the one. But we don't really want that guy anymore. What are you guys doing? The geologists. We've conquered this entire mountain, guys. Stop. Move on, guys. Move on. We'll send them. There's quite a lot of mountains, actually. So we'll send them over here. Go and do your thing over there. And the same with these guys as well. That you've kind of explored this entire mountain. We know there's gold there. We know there's a little bit of coal. So you guys work over in this mountain here. Brilliant. And yeah, then once again, let's go for another green farm. Yeah, like somewhere like that. Cool. And then I'll readjust. I'll readjust the working area there. Yeah, this guy's got loads of stone to work with. We've got loads of stone left there. I might get some of these pioneers, actually. Let's get all five of those guys. Oh, that's my phone on vibrating away. I'll just chuck that behind me. Yeah, we'll just capture this little bit of stone here. We probably don't need all five pioneers. We could probably do that job with one pioneer, but whatever. That's cool. And then at the same time, I think we should definitely go for a weaponsmith here. Let's see where we could squeeze in a barracks. Like, we could squeeze in a barracks here. Oh, that's a beautiful spot for a barracks there. What a strange building, actually. Look at that. It's got like a tin roof. Rusted. Let's not put that there. It's not rusted at all, obviously. It's just a song. It's the Love Shack. It's the barracks. It's the Love Shack. Whatever you guys are into. Whatever you Roman soldiers are into. I guess there's no women, actually, is there? They're just all men. I don't know how people are produced here in the settlers, because everyone is a man. Okay. Yeah, let's drop. I'm not sure exactly how to lay this out, guys. We're not going to be able to squeeze both of these in, are we? I'll give it a try anyway. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen for sure. Okay, no. So we'll put the weaponsmith here as close as possible. There we go. I wonder if I could have squeezed in two weaponsmiths there. Ah, oh, should we have done that? Okay, let's try. Let's try that. Okay. Let's see if we could maybe have got two weaponsmiths in there. Okay, no, we couldn't have... what a waste of time. We couldn't get two weaponsmiths in there and be nice and efficient, so whatever. We'll do that. Okay. So we might be producing troops soon, then. I can go on the weaponsmith here. We'll go to the production... Oh, no, that's the vehicle hall. What am I doing, guys? No wonder it looked so weird. We know what the Roman barracks is like. We know what it looks like. Why did I do that, man? I'm glad I caught that, actually. Yeah, I thought this was the barracks. Nope. We already know what the barracks looks like. We've not been playing these for an entire level already. What am I talking about, guys? Did you guys catch that as well, or are you just as shocked as I am at how much of an idiot I am? So we've got more coal here and things like that. Okay. How's this going? Green farm's going well. I tell you what, let's should we try and get a couple of shovels? Let's get like three shovels and three hammers. And maybe a couple more builders is what I'm thinking. There we go. We'll request those shovels and we'll request those diggers even. And then when the shovels become available, someone should pick those up straight away. I think at the same time we can go for a large residence as well. If I can find it, guys. I'm always getting lost in this setup. Town buildings. Is it one of these? I just normally just go straight through the tabs and try and figure it out. There we go. Let's just dot that there then, straight in the middle. And we've captured this land as well. We might as well just get the whole thing. Just claim the whole thing. And then we'll send them maybe down here. Maybe down there to capture a little bit of land. Tell you what, let's go for a tower here as well, just to capture some land here. I have a feeling we're going really slow. I tell you what, I'm going to hit three on the numpad there. I'm going to try and remember to do that every episode. I did. There was a point where I was doing it all the time. We'll crush that tower. And yeah, let's go for a little bit more food production. We've got the fish coming, so these guys have a little bit of food. Yeah. Could be better though. And then here we're just gonna store shovels. In fact, we'll just store all tools, mainly shovels though. Cool. And then maybe we'll get a nice supply of shovels just to be sure, just to be extra sure. And then once this is built, we can think about more food. Should we go for meat straight away or should we go for bread? I'm thinking bread is a good idea. Where's the nearest river? There is a river up there. I'm sure this is... But there's no space next to it for anything. Never mind. There we go. We'll squeeze that grain mill in. Hopefully it's not going to get in the way. Nah. It looks okay. It looks like it's all good. And then we'll get a couple of waterworks then. Could waterworks get water from lakes? Because this looks like fresh water. Look at this. There's definitely a difference in the water here. Like, this is really shiny. I just noticed these pioneers. We'll send them. Just join these two little bits of land up then for us. Well, actually, we'll send them down here to capture all this stone. What is this? I just saw a load of red on the map there. That scared the crap out of me. On the mini-map, I just saw loads of red. Dun, dun, dun. We'll send them up here. This is going to be our bottleneck, I think. I think if we can crush all of the towers, that would be cool. We'll crush you as well. And we'll send these troops up here. Actually, we'll leave this guy down here in case we build any more. Keep going. And look at all this grass here is telling us that we're going to need another grain farm. another green farm, I think, yeah, something like that. I'm pretty sure we can capture water from this lake here. Like, this looks like salt water. I'm not sure if that's a mechanic of the game or not, but that's really choppy seas, and then this lake is beautifully soft there and full of fish. So let's give it a try. I guess we're going to have to do it around here. If not, I've placed these here specifically, like, if we can't get water from this lake, they can walk a little bit further and capture the water from this river. I'm not exactly sure how it works in Settlers 4, to be honest, guys. I'm not 100% sure. And I guess right next to the water is going to be a good spot for a bakery or two. Let's wait until we capture that tower, actually. Build that tower, it's got all the resources it needs, so once that tower is captured, we're going to claim a little bit more land here, and we'll be able to squeeze in some bakeries here. Right, I just had to pause it again, my door popped open again, how annoying. The wind is blowing like crazy outside my house, guys. It's obviously creating some vacuums throughout the house. My house is like 100 years old, so it's not really very well sealed. So I can see the trees outside just like swaying around like crazy. It's obviously, like I say, doing strange things with the air pressure in my house, popping doors open and stuff. Yeah, so now we've got this tower. Let's squeeze in. Three bakeries? Screw it, three bakeries, there we go, and we'll crush that tower because that's right on the edge. We really don't want that. Have we found anything interesting here? More gold, boring old gold. A little bit of coal, stone, quite a lot of stone. And yeah, what we really do want is iron. We have one iron mine at the moment, which kind of isn't the best. Not the most efficient thing. We could think about mana as well, but everywhere is really flat, guys. Huh. Yeah, there's a little bit of a hill here, actually. Maybe we could squeeze a vine on there. Let's go for another tower then, and we'll crush this. How are we doing then? We've got the green farm. Did we build a scythe for this green farm? I don't think so. I think we forgot to do that, so yeah, let's request that, thank you. Got this guy doing his thing here. This thing is churning away. Not the most efficient setup, really, but whatever. Whatever, we'll make it work. This large residence, I thought that was completed there. It looks kind of complete. But apparently not. We need one more piece of stone for that. And I'm tempted to go for another stone mine, just so we have a nice supply of stone. Or we could do it the other way and go for a storage area that purely accepts stone and nothing else. Maybe we can do that. Did we build that barracks? Oh, we did. We did. Are we getting any troops? Oh, no. Okay, we haven't requested any troops whatsoever. To start with, I'm going to go for a level... yeah, we're going to go for level 1, guys. We can get medics as well. Do medics just have swords? They can heal wounded comrades. Let's go for a few medics for sure. Yeah, I think the medics use swords, so let's go for like a 30-70 split. We need a lot of bowmen to start with for sure. Let's get a few medics. I'm going to request like 20 medics. 15. 20. There we go. 20 medics. And the weaponsmith needs a little bit more coal still. So we still have things. Yeah, we still need things. I guess as well. Okay, let's go for one more grain farm. Where can we put it? Somewhere like that. Thank you. We'll grow it on this grass, which apparently someone told me that's the best place for it, on the grass there. So we'll do that. And then at the same time, we'll go for... where am I looking? We're going to get some meat. We're going to raise some livestock, some sheep. There we go. Raise some sheep. Right there. Yeah, that kind of works, I think. something like this. Let's just mess around with the working areas a little bit. Yeah, there we go. Sheep and... Oh, I'm tempted to go for two. But we won't do that for now. We do need a slaughterhouse though, so we'll go for that. And of course then we're going to need an axe. But we already have an axe. Brilliant. I said we already have a... we have a spare saw as well, so maybe we could go for a sawmill. There's room like there. Okay, we'll make use of that. Thank you. And I'm going to change the working area here just to capture. This is the stone cutter. I'm just going to capture as much stone as possible there. Brilliant. We've got a few troops there. So I'll tell you what, let's send them down there. This should hopefully be our only tower. Where's the other tower? What's here? Okay. And we've captured an area here for stone. So if we can find out where these pioneers are, they're doing their job capturing absolutely useless terrain there. We have no use for that whatsoever. So let's send them up here and just to claim this area. That makes sense. Where's the rest of them? Okay. They did their job there. They helped us out quite a lot there, actually clearing a little bit of space. But their skills are needed elsewhere. With this gold down here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get one of these pioneers. The first one I see. There's one here. Yeah, we'll grab that guy. He's probably the closest. Just to double check this gold. We know there is gold here. This is the first bit of gold we've ever found. So we know there's gold there for sure. Obviously we can see it there. But I just want to get that guy to clear over that land. So we just know exactly where it is. Get our pioneers to just clear directly on top of that gold for us. Start on top of the gold instead of starting here and working their way across. Brilliant. Yeah, we'll get the geologist. Come on, pal. Brilliant. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go for a little bit of wine here. This is like the steepest slope I've seen so far. So we'll get a couple vineyards on there. Brilliant. Yeah, something like that will work for us. Very nice. And then as well, let's do the whole thing. Let's go for a small temple wherever it is. Small temple, yeah, whatever, we'll squeeze that in there. And then a large temple. I really don't want to put it here actually. The large temple's location is pretty much irrelevant. Obviously need the small temple as close to the wine as possible, but I'm pretty sure you don't need to put the large temple anywhere nearby, so we'll dump that there. That's kind of out of the way. And then at the same time, I think we'll go for a large residence as well. Yeah, we're suddenly making a lot of troops and we don't really have the people to support that. Especially now, look at this, we've only got 5 carriers minimum, so I'm going to crank that up. So the minimum the amount of carriers will ever be is going to be 50. Yeah, okay, and I'll tell you what, we'll get 2 extra diggers, 2 extra builders as well, just to get that as a nice round number. We needed a couple extra hammers there, or 1 extra hammer, but I'll go for a couple anyway, and then we'll go for like 5 more shovels as well, just to be sure. We've finally built the storage area. I'm going to purely accept wood and stone there. So at the times where we don't have any building projects going on, when things are slow, there's not going to be a huge load of logs just stood here doing nothing. That means these guys aren't going to be happy. The woodcutters aren't going to be happy because they're going to constantly have a job to do until the storage area is full. It means that the stone cutters as well, we've got a nice supply of stone as well. In the same way. Now, I've got 1 stone cutter on this whole area here, which seems to be working well. He's working his way through it. Actually, take that area first. So we could do the same here. We could get another stone cutter. Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. So we've got a geologist here to do his job, and yeah, there's a nice area here. I think we could probably get 2 gold mines in. Possibly. Is this the gold mine? Yeah, okay. Let's do 1 there for sure. And then... Look at that. It's not ideal, is it? It's not ideal. Saw this mountain in the way. I think we can melt snow, though. Our priests can melt snow. Obviously, we're nowhere near building that large temple. Look at that. It's just been leveled, and that's it. So, yeah. Once that large temple comes, maybe we can melt a bit of snow. Let's focus on that one gold mine for now, though. And where's that geologist? There he is. There was some coal up here. We can see the remaining little bits. So let's claim that coal again. And what else? What else is there? Let's send these guys down here. We're desperately in need of iron, though. For sure. Let's send these guys down here and see what we can find in terms of iron. We'll get that guy to keep exploring there because it looks like there's a nice vein of coal. More gold again. I can't find any iron, though, for the life of me. And I'm just going to double check the amount of towers we have. We've got one tower right there, so that's the one tower we're going to be defending. Once we start getting a little bit of gold, of course, we're going to need a gold smelter as well. There's a lot of projects going on at the moment. It looks like we're working our way through most of them, actually. Yeah, so all we've got left is this large residence and the large temple here. If we have a look at the amount of beds we have compared to the amount of carriers we have, we can destroy one of these. For sure. Down to 100. Yeah, we don't want to destroy the other one. Otherwise, we'll have, what, 30 people on strike? Yeah, we don't want that. I think at the same time, we can just go for another large residence as well. Let's just keep it coming. Let's just keep going for it. We built that stone cutter, so we have a pickaxe lying around there anyway. That's good to see. So I think we're all good. I think we're all good, guys. What do you think? We've got the grain farms up and running. You need a scythe. I'm sure we requested one. Or did we? Yeah, I might have built an extra one. Okay, we'll go for a couple of scythes. Screw it. So we don't have to think about that again. And I'll tell you what, while we're at it, let's go for another grain farm. Here. Yeah, look at that. Spot on. We've got the sheep ranch with one tiny little lamb. Look at how adorable that is. What kind of noise is that? It's like a heavy smoker lamb. Really heavy smoker lamb. He's been on those cigars too much. It's really like he's got a frog in his throat there. Oh, poor little thing. Might as well put it out of his misery and just eat it. Eat it right there and then. I tell you what, how's the water supply doing? It looks like it's quite in demand, water is, by the looks of things. Look at these bakeries. They're stocked up very nicely on flour, but it looks like there's no water. Can you not get water from the river then? I thought you could. Can we get water from the... Have we made any bread whatsoever? I'm not sure. Okay, let's change the working area to here and see if someone pops out. Okay, someone instantly comes out when I change the working area to on the river. I thought we could get water from the lakes. See, no one comes out when the working area is set to the lake. No one comes out when it's set to the sea. But then I set his working area to overlap with the river and instantly is out the door. So we've had these bloody bakeries for ages now, like half of the game. Oh man, half of the episode we've had these bloody bakeries producing zilch, producing nothing for us. Look at this, this grain farm is almost maxed out here. The grain mill is maxed out as well. We've got nothing else to do. Oh man, how annoying. We could probably build another grain mill here, actually. Let's build another grain mill here and then stop production there. Yeah, in fact, let's just crush it, screw it. Screw it, we'll just crush it. We keep the resource anyway. We get to keep the worker. Look at him. Look at the stare on his face. He was just there chilling, and then the building collapsed around him. And then people, the only evidence, the only rubble that was left, people have collected that. It's like, oh my god, what just happened? I was just chilling, just getting paid to do nothing. 1,000-yard stare. We're coming up to the end of the episode, guys. Like I said at the start, I accidentally stopped the recording and started again, so I don't know exactly how long we've been rocking for here, but it looks like it's probably half an hour, so let's just tidy things up and get it all done with. We've actually cleaned. Our pioneers have done a nice job and worked their way around this snow here and claimed the whole thing for us. So maybe we can... I was going to say, maybe now that we've claimed that area, we can squeeze a gold mine in, but apparently not. We're still working on this large temple because we need gold. Ah, I completely forgot about that. We need gold. And does this guy have anything in his area? No. I don't think he does, so let's destroy that. No need for him. And okay, where could I relocate him? Just down here, screw it, we'll stick him down there. Okay, things are looking up, guys, things are looking good. Obviously I sped up the game on the numpad there, so time's been traveling like crazy. So I bet the enemy is doing well better than us. Yeah, everyone's doing well better than us. So yeah, we've got some catching up to do next week, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know if you guys like the game being sped up, so we can get kind of more content and more interesting things. There's a load, I'm sure. What was it, like 18 episodes of the Dark Tribe, 18 missions that comes to mind, or 12 missions? There are a lot of missions to get through in the Dark Tribe, so having things three times as fast is maybe a good idea. Anyway, let me know what you're thinking, guys. Let me know your thoughts and feelings and any advice you guys have got. I'm all ears for that. And I will see you guys next time for another episode of Settlers Saturday.